Pourquoi អង្គជំនុំជម្រះប្រកាសបន្តកិច្ចដំណើរការនៃទិសសម្ដនាការសម្ដនាការនៅព្រឹកនេះអង្គជំរះនឹងធ្វើសម្ដនាការបន្តស្ដាប់អក្ខីកម្មសាក្សីរីឆាតរុតមែនតាមរយៈប្រព័ន្ធទូរទស្សន៍ពីថារតអាមេរិកហើយនៅរុស្ស៊ីលនេះចាប់ផ្ដើមពីម៉ោង 6រសៀលអង្គជំរះនឹងធ្វើសម្ដនាការស្ដាប់ស្ដីថ្លែងរៀបរាប់អំពីទុកសោកវេទនានិងព្យាសនកម្ម របស់ដើមម្ដងរដ្ឋប្រវេណីចំនួន2រូបដែលគាត់អះអាងថាគាត់បានទទួលរងនៅក្នុងរបបកម្ពុជាប្រជាធិបតេយ្យសូមភិក្ខុនិងសាធារណជនជ្រាបក្រុមជាសម្ដនាការលោកត្រីកញ្ញាជាសីហងឡើងរាយការណ៍ពីស្ថានភាពវត្តមានអវត្តមានភិក្ខុនៅបុគ្គលដែលអង្គជំរះក៏ហង្ជឿនឲ្យចូលរួមនៅក្នុងកិច្ចដំណើរការសម្ដនាការព្រឹកនេះ
សូមគោរពលោកប្រធានសម្រាប់សវនកម្មនៅថ្ងៃនេះកឡាបញ្ជីកាត់សម្គាល់ឃើញថាគ្រប់ភាគីទាំងអស់នៅរឿងក្តីនេះមានវត្តមានដោយឡែកលោកនួនជាមានវត្តមាននៅបន្ទប់ឃុំខ្លួនខាងក្រោមសាលសវនកម្មនេះដែលលោកស្នើសុំលះបង់សិទ្ធិមានវត្តមានដោយផ្ទាល់ពីបន្ទប់សវនកម្មលិខិតលះបង់សិទ្ធិរបស់ជនជាប់ចោទនួនជាបានប្រកាសដល់កឡាបញ្ជីរួចហើយសាក្សីដែលត្រូវមកផ្ដល់សក្ខីកម្មនៅថ្ងៃនេះគឺលោករីឆាដុតមែនតាមរយៈប្រព័ Merci, Monsieur le Président. Nous n'avons plus de questions pour le témoin.
Je vous remercie, Monsieur le Président. Bonjour, Monsieur Dodman. Je m'appelle Anta Guissé et je suis co-avocat international de Monsieur Kyusampan. Et je vais à mon tour vous poser quelques questions. Ça ne devrait pas être trop long.
Good morning.
Bonjour.
Good morning.
Lors de sa déposition devant cette chambre, votre consoeur Elizabeth Baker a évoqué les préparatifs en vue de votre voyage de décembre 78 au Cambodge. Et voilà ce qu'elle a indiqué. Et là, je vais citer plutôt son ouvrage en anglais, When the War Was Over, et en français, Les Larmes du Cambodge. L'ERN, le passage que je citais se trouve à l'ERN 00638654 en français, et en anglais 00238115. C'est la page 402 en anglais. Voilà ce qu'elle dit à propos de ses préparatifs. Dodman et moi avions été informés de la situation critique du Cambodge avant notre arrivée. J'avais discuté avec des experts du département d'État, du ministère de la Défense et de la CIA à Washington. À Bangkok et à Pékin, j'avais rencontré des spécialistes politiques et militaires américains, français, canadiens, australiens et chinois. Aucun ne m'avait prédit une guerre à grande échelle entre le Vietnam et le Cambodge. Tout au plus, selon eux, les Vietnamiens pousseraient jusqu'au Mékong et s'y arrêteraient, satisfaits de contrôler la rive orientale du fleuve, avant de poursuivre vers la capitale au cours d'une offensive ultérieure. L'un des plus éminents experts américains, un vieil ami, m'assura à Bangkok que mes craintes au sujet des rumeurs de guerre et de ma propre sécurité étaient sans fondement. Ce sera du gâteau, conclut-il. Fin de citation. Ma première question est de savoir si vous vous souvenez, Monsieur Dudman, si vous avez pris comme Madame Baker des précautions et pris des informations sur la situation au Cambodge avant de préparer votre voyage de 78.
I do not remember
what preparations I made. I'm sure I talked to many people, including officials, but I can't recall what I did exactly.
Est-ce que vous vous souvenez si, comme il a été dit à Elizabeth Baker, si on vous disait également qu'il n'y avait pas a priori à craindre d'offensive immédiate.
I don't remember any such assurance that I received.
À propos de ce conflit latent en cours entre le Cambodge et le Vietnam, est-ce que toujours dans le cadre des préparatifs de ce voyage et surtout dans le cadre de votre travail sur la région et notamment sur le Vietnam, est-ce que vous avez eu à effectuer des recherches sur les questions frontalières entre le Vietnam et le Cambodge et notamment les discussions relatives à la ligne Brévier?
I don't recall what research I may have done.
ខ្ញុំបានធ្វើការសិក្សាស្រាវជ្រាវអ្វីទេលោកស្រី?
Il y a deux jours ou hier, je ne sais plus, vous aviez évoqué, vous avez eu l'occasion de réécouter les propos tenus par Pol Pot lors de votre entrevue de 78, dans l'extrait qui a été joué à l'audience par mon confrère de Nyon Chea, je confirme que c'était bien hier, Pol Pot évoque les volontés expansionnistes du Vietnam et parle également du fait qu'il ne s'agit pas que d'un problème frontalier. Est-ce que vous vous souvenez de cette partie de cet entretien et est-ce que ça correspondait à vos connaissances de l'époque, si vous vous en souvenez, des volontés politiques du Vietnam?
I don't remember that conversation, so I don't know how to compare it with what I knew at the time.
ខ្ញុំមិនដឹងថាតើត្រូវធ្វើការប្រៀបធៀបទៅនឹងអ្វីដែលខ្ញុំបានដឹងពេលនោះដោយរបៀបណាបានទេ?
Est-ce que vous vous souvenez à l'époque, nous étions en pleine guerre froide, c'est aussi un point qui est évoqué par Pol Pot dans ses propos, à savoir un rapprochement entre le Vietnam et l'Union soviétique. Est-ce que cela rafraîchit votre mémoire par rapport aux événements de l'époque?
I don't recall.
ខ្ញុំនឹងមិនឃើញទេលោកស្រី.
Dans votre rapport effectué en janvier 79, document E3-3290 et à l'ERN 00419207, vous évoquez la présence chinoise au Cambodge, et voilà ce que vous dites. Je vais vous citer en anglais puisque nous n'avons pas de traduction française. À l'attention des interprètes, c'est juste avant le paragraphe Where are the rich? Nowhere in our travels did we see any sizable body of Cambodian troops or weapons. And the only signs we saw of Chinese assistance in the country were two MIGs flying over Phnom Penh one day and the line of 56 Chinese trucks driving north from Kampong Som while a Chinese freighter had discharged them. Fin de citation. Monsieur Dudman, est-ce que cette partie de votre rapport vous rafraîchit la mémoire et est-ce que vous vous souvenez avoir bien vu deux MiG voler au-dessus de Phnom Penh?
I do not remember that.
Je ne me souviens pas.
Lors de sa déposition, et vous l'avez aussi évoqué brièvement, vous avez évoqué, Elizabeth Baker a évoqué la mort de Caldwell et les hypothèses qui ont été formulées à l'époque. Toujours dans votre rapport E3-3290, voilà ce que vous écrivez. À nouveau, je vais passer à l'anglais, vous dites, vous évoquez les, ce qui a été dit par Chun Prasit. Prasit described the shooting as a political act to discredit us in the world and to show that we cannot protect our friends. He said the terrorists knew that the visit of the first three Westerners to Cambodia was a significant one and that Cambodia's reputation in the world would be greatly damaged if they were assassinated. Only days later, that Cambodian regime would be driven in to hiding by your Vietnamese assault. Là encore, même question, M. Dedman, est-ce que cette partie de votre rapport vous rafraîchit la mémoire et est-ce que vous vous souvenez que Chun Prasit a évoqué dès le premier jour l'hypothèse d'une attaque vietnamienne?
I didn't understand your question.
Khnyom at yul samnuo lok srey te.
Je vous demande si cette partie de votre rapport vous rafraîchit la mémoire et si vous vous souvenez bien que Chun Prasit a évoqué l'hypothèse d'une attaque par le Vietnam, enfin d'une attaque terroriste par le Vietnam, comme une thèse dès le premier jour de cet assassinat.
I really don't remember my thinking at the time. What I wrote at the time was what I knew then, or thought I knew, but I don't have any recollection of anything further.
Dans le même rapport, vous avez également évoqué les propos de Yang Sari, toujours au même ERN, donc 00419212. Je cite en anglais. Yang Sari said sadly that the visit had been intended to present to the world the concrete situation in his country, but that the terrorist incident had cast a very dark cloud on this effort. The Cambodian government later attributed the terrorist act to Vietnam, its enemy in a current war, in which there was a temporary lull at the time of our visit. Fin de citation. Même question, est-ce que cela vous rappelle des souvenirs? Ça correspond, j'ai bien compris, à votre rapport de l'époque et ce que vous aviez indiqué juste après les faits. Dernier extrait que je veux vous soumettre sur, au sujet de votre rapport de 78. Vous avez évoqué certaines hypothèses, vous avez indiqué à l'audience, répondant aux questions de monsieur le coprocureur, qu'il y avait plusieurs thèses à l'époque et qu'il y avait de la spéculation. Vous vous souvenez que beaucoup de bruits ont circulé à la suite de l'assassinat de Caldwell. Et voilà ce que vous avez indiqué à la fin de votre rapport sur l'hypothèse d'une attaque fomentée par le gouvernement Khmer Rouge lui-même. Voilà ce que vous avez indiqué. Finally, was there any possibility that the government could have arranged the attack? A dispatch from Hanoi later reported that Caldwell had recently turned against Cambodia and conjectured that the government may have wanted to prevent what they feared would be an adverse report. This seems out of the question. The Cambodian government had everything to lose from the incident. If, for for some uncountable reason, the authorities had wanted us killed, they could have contrived an accident or ambush to kill us all. And from lengthy conversation with Caldwell up to a few hours of his death, I know that he remained fully sympathetic to the Cambodian revolution. Première question, est-ce que vous vous souvenez de votre conclusion de l'époque et est-ce que vous confirmez, première question, est-ce que vous vous souvenez de cette conclusion, est-ce que c'est bien ce qui vous avait semblé en 78 que cet attentat n'avait aucun intérêt pour le gouvernement cambodgien.
I have read late, just today, again, what I wrote at the time, but I have no recollection of what led me to write that. I don't remember those circumstances.
Bien. Je vous remercie de la patience dont vous avez preuve, M. Dodman, et je n'ai plus de questions à ce stade, M. le Président.
ក៏លោកត្រីជាក្រុមមានទំនួលទេបាទហើយសម្ណការព្រឹកនេះដល់ពេលសម្រាកហើយដោយសារការធ្វើសម្ណការនៅព្រឹកនេះបានចប់មុនពេលកំណត់អង្គជំនះប្រកាសសម្រាកចាប់ពីនៅព្រឹកនេះត្រឹមនេះហើយសម្ណការលើកបន្តធ្វើនៅរសៀលថ្ងៃនេះដែលនឹងចាប់ផ្ដើមពីម៉ោង 1 រសៀលហើយសម្ណការនៅរសៀលថ្ងៃនេះអង្គជំនះនឹងធ្វើសម្ណការស្ដាប់ ស្រីថ្លៃរៀបរាប់ទុកសោកវេទនារបស់ដើមដឹងរដ្ឋរនីជំនួន2រូបដែលបានអះអាងថាខ្លួនបានទទួលរងនៅក្នុងអំឡុងរបបកម្ពុជាប្រជាធិបតេយ្យដល់7មេសាឆ្នាំ5ដល់6មករាឆ្នាំ9សូមភាគីរួមទាំងបុគ្គលិកគ្រប់គ្រងកិច្ចដំណើរការសម្ណការជ្រាបនិងអញ្ជើញចូលរួមតាមពេលវេលាបានកំណត់នេះហើយអង្គជំនះសូមអរគុណចំពោះលោករីឆាតឌុតមែនសក្ខីកម្មរបស់លោកនឹងអាចរួមភាកទានក្នុងការស្វែងរកការពិតនៅរឿងក្តីនេះ ដំណើរការសម្ណការស្ដាប់លក្ខីកម្មរបស់លោកក្នុងឋានៈជាសាក្សីនៅពេលនេះបានដល់ទីបញ្ចប់ហើយលោករីឆាតឌុតមែនលោកអាចសម្រាកបានហើយហើយសូមជូនពរលោករីឆាតឌុតមែនសូមមានសុខភាពល្អជួបតែសំណាងល្អហើយអង្គជំនះក៏សូមអរគុណផងដែរចំពោះលោកមេធាវីជាសិនបារ៉េតនិងលោកថូតឡូវែលជាបុគ្គលិកជំនួយការមេធាវីដែលបានចូលរួមជួយជ្រោមជ្រែងអង្គជំនះក្នុងអំឡុងពេល
ដែលលោករីឆាតឌុតមែនផ្ដល់សក្ខីកម្ម3ថ្ងៃរយៈពេល6ម៉ោងកន្លងមកនេះឥឡូវនេះបានដល់ទីបញ្ចប់ហើយលោកមេធាវីជេកសិនបារ៉េតនិងលោកថូតឡូវែលអាចសម្រាកបានហើយThank you Mr. President. Thank you. សូមអរគុណលោកប្រធានបាទជម្រាបលាលោករីឆាតឌុតមែនសូមជួយថាមាន
Yes, before we break, Mr. President, yesterday I mentioned my recollection that an issue we discussed yesterday that had been raised by the new Chia team questioning or challenging the use of victim impact statements relating to the facts of the case. I did look at the transcript and I did find where this issue was discussed and ruled upon. On the 20th of May 2013, this was about 1 week before the victim impact testimony was to begin. The court scheduled argument at the end of the day to hear from the parties on the issue of to what extent prosecutors and the defense would be allowed to question the civil parties during the victim impact. You'll find this at pages 100 to 111, end of that, of the 20th of May, E1/193.1. My colleague, Mr. Rayner, made 10 points to this court that emphasized the importance of being able to rely on factual information from these civil parties. He emphasized, quote, that civil parties should be questioned on all issues of relevance, that evidence relating to suffering and the occurrence of the crimes was inextricably linked. He talked about how the civil parties were victims of the force movement, whose evidence would go to the heart of the trial. He noted that the defense should be provided the opportunity to challenge that evidence. He stated, I quote, both the prosecution and defense have been proceeding on the basis that full examination would take place, end of quote. And he noted the duty of the chamber to ascertain the truth, which mandated that these civil parties testifying in the victim impact phase be treated the same as prior civil parties. In response, this is what Mr. Pope, Nguyen Chea's counsel, said, and I quote, Mr. President, I don't think I would ever be saying this in a court of law, but I think I agree with all 10 submissions from the prosecution. So we fully concur with the submissions of the prosecution. He was then followed by the Houston Penn defense, Mr. Birkin, who also concurred with our position. Bringing people here for them to speak only about their harm suffered, without them explaining the reasons and experience that led to this harm, seems unusual to me and incongruous in such a trial. It's difficult to distinguish the origin, the factual aspects of the harm, from the harm itself. Included, it seems to me that it is normal that these people come next week, that aspects linked to harm slide to some things that are factual. We will manage as we can face the situation in order to try to examine them. The next day, on the 21st of May, again at the end of the day, this is a document, the transcript for the 21st of May 2013, E1/194.1. On page 119 in English. The trial chamber issued its ruling on this issue, stating, I quote, there has been a mutual consent amongst all parties, and the chamber decides that the parties may question the civil parties on relevant factual issues subject to the time limitations already announced. So when we started the victim impact proceedings, everyone in this court knew that they would be examined not just on harm, but on the relevant facts. That is why all the parties asked questions on that, and that is why this chamber cited that evidence in its judgment. It's very unfortunate to me that these arguments were put to the court yesterday. It's not an isolated incident in the appeal brief that was filed by the Nguyen Chea team. And on a going forward basis, I might suggest that the Nguyen Chea team wishes to make motions to this court, it file a motion and not simply attach portions of an appeal brief, which are being litigated before the Supreme Court. We take issue with many, many characterizations like this, which misstate what has happened before this court. In any event, it's important that the record be clear. That in the past trial, this court announced very clearly that these civil parties would be examined on factual issues, and the same should happen today when we start. Thank you.
A Perhaps it's easier if I add something and then you can answer to both. In this context, I would like to refer to a decision the Nunchia team has referred to in their appeals brief, and that's E267/3 from 2nd of May 2013. So my guess is that Yeah, I just wanted to add that there was a decision E2673 from 2nd May 2013 dealing with the issue at hand, and I guess it was probably the basis for the debate in court a couple of days later. It was also referenced by the Nunchia defense in the appeal. And specifically, page 9 of this decision appears to deal with all the issues raised yesterday by the Nunchia defense. It clearly says that cross-examination will be allowed. And it also clearly, in paragraph 21, says how generally how the trial chamber will deal with civil party statements, including impact statements, on trial level. The reason I didn't mention it yesterday is because since it was mentioned in the appeal, I thought it was obvious, and the only thing I tried to do is highlight what I thought was probably a misquote of another decision. But just to add to the arguments.
Thank you, Judge Fentz. And in reaction to what the deputy co-prosecutor just said, of course, yesterday I revisited our appeal brief, and I also revisited the decision of the trial judge in this respect. It seems to me we have a completely different interpretation as to the ruling on this matter by the trial chamber. To us, to me, it seems clear there's a distinction between testimony given by witnesses or civil parties normally, while sitting there and giving testimony to facts, and the phenomenon of civil impact testimony. Now, obviously, if a civil party talks about suffering, he or she would relate to some underlying facts. However, the whole idea of the distinction also made by the trial chamber is that it is, in essence, no evidence, evidence that will not be used against the accused ultimately in his judgment. That's how we understood it then, and that's how we still understand what is it. You've seen in our appeal brief that we quoted your decision, and the mere fact that it is only 10 minutes time that was allotted to us to ask some questions to the civil party giving civil impact testimony is one element that confirms our interpretation and understanding. The fact, as mentioned yesterday, that you asked the defense's permission to continue while Nunchia was absent because of sick. We have been always acting on the basis of a fundamental difference in suffering testimony on the one hand and real testimony to the evidence on the other hand.
At the time, and that is in response to Deputy Co-Prosecutor
At the time,
of course, we were fully agreeing with Prosecutor Keith Rayner when we said that we needed equal opportunity to question. However, that was not the standard practice. The standard practice was you have another 10 minutes to ask some follow-up questions.
Plus, I think
we should be reminded of a difference between, on the one hand, a civil party coming here to testify, and then, at the end, giving civil impact testimony, and this whole group, which is now scheduled, which is just coming here for half hour or for an hour. In any case, I believe, and that's the reason of our appeal, there is a very different interpretation possible as to what the law is. The defense team are lawyers. Alternative, our proposal alternative is that we need the equal time to question the upcoming civil party. So that's, I think, how it should be interpreted. That's how you should see our appeal brief. And last remark, following some remarks of the prosecutor, the reason why we just sent you excerpts from the appeal brief is because of reasons of expediency and of fastness. That's the reason that we did it. We simply do not have the resources to always come up with full responses to motions, especially in light of the fact that the civil party testimony impact testimony was already scheduled. So again, summarizing, what apparently seems clear to other parties didn't seem clear to us at all.
Très brièvement, une citation d'une de vos décisions, enfin d'un mémo, un document E236/5/3/2, pour que vous compreniez mon intervention d'hier et la distinction que nous avions pu comprendre claire entre les deux types de dépositions, à savoir une déposition de partie civile qui vient pour témoigner des faits et une partie civile qui vient pour déposer sur ses souffrances. Dans ce mémo qui a trait à la possibilité d'une liaison vidéo avec la partie civile TCCP 13, vous avez indiqué ceci, je cite, le but des audiences consacrées à l'incidence des crimes allégués sur les victimes est de donner aux parties civiles l'occasion de présenter des éléments de preuve à l'appui de leur demande de réparation morale et collective, règle 23.1b du règlement intérieur. Fin de citation. Dans mon entendement, lorsque l'on parle de demande de réparation, nous sommes dans un deuxième temps, à savoir qu'on a déjà décidé qu'il y avait une condamnation et qu'ensuite on s'intéresse dans un deuxième temps à la demande de réparation. Et pour nous, et c'est pour ça que lors du premier procès, nous avons peu interrogé les parties civiles qui venaient témoigner sur leurs souffrances et que nous avions compris qu'il y avait une distinction entre les audiences pour lesquelles elles apparaissaient en tant que témoins des faits en même temps et celles où c'était uniquement concentré sur la demande de réparation morale et collective. Dans ce mémo, c'est, nous semble-t-il, ce que vous indiquez. Donc, qu'il soit bien clair que pour nous, il ne s'agit pas de dire qu'effectivement, on peut complètement différencier les faits et les souffrances, puisqu'il faut un minimum que la partie civile évoque les faits, mais des faits qui lui sont propres et des faits qui doivent être examinés par la Chambre en vue de la demande de réparation qui intervient dans un deuxième temps, puisque nous sommes d'accord, il ne peut y avoir de demande de réparation que s'il y a une culpabilité qui est prononcée. Dans ces conditions, c'est le sens de la clarification aujourd'hui, puisque nous aussi, nous avons noté au paragraphe 30, il me semble, de notre mémoire d'appel, qu'il y avait eu une utilisation massive des déclarations des parties civiles qui étaient censées avoir très simplement à la demande de réparation morale et collective et qui ont été utilisées comme des éléments de preuve à charge. Voilà la clarification que nous demandons aujourd'hui, étant précisé, encore une fois, que nous avons toujours essayé de faire preuve de clairvoyance dans les questions que nous posons et que nous avons l'intention de continuer à faire ceci. Maintenant, si il y a des éléments nouveaux, et encore une fois, je précise que éléments nouveaux pour nous, ce n'est pas toujours simple lorsque nous n'avons que des éléments ténus relatifs aux parties civiles avant qu'elles viennent de déposer. Donc, ce n'est que à la vue et à l'audition de la déposition de ces parties civiles que nous saurons si nous devons avoir besoin de plus de temps pour les contre-interroger.
I'll be very brief. What we just heard is revisionist history. Read the transcript from the 20th of May 2013. There is no ambiguity. There is no room at all for Mr. Coppe and the defense to suggest that they were unaware of the purpose of the victim impact civil parties. It could not be clearer. The exact issue we were discussing was the extent to which the civil parties heard in victim impact would be testified about factual information and whether that could be used. That was the issue. Read the 10 points from Mr. Rayner, read the responses from the defense counsel. This is crystal clear. This is an issue that they have made up after the judgment, after losing. It is as simple as that.
Mr. Chairman, on the point of the ពីពេលហើយនៅសម្ញគោនិយាយហើយថ្ងៃនេះនិយាយដោយមិនបានគ្រងទុកជាមុនទៀតផងហើយអ្វីដែលបានលើកឡើងនេះអង្គជំរះបានជម្រាបជូនមិត្តសម្ញហើយថាមានមូលដ្ឋានក្នុងការពិនិត្យពិចារណាសម្រាប់លើបញ្ហានេះហើយបាទឥឡូវនេះប្រកបឲ្យអនុរិយមន្ត្រីឃុំឃាំងនងខ្លួនជួយជាប់ចោតខេត្តសំផនទៅកាន់បន្ទប់រងចាំខាងក្រោមសាធារណការនេះហើយនឹងប្រកបឲ្យនាំខ្លួនគាត់ត្រឡប់មកចូលរួមសាធារណការនៅក្នុងបន្ទប់សាធារណការនេះវិញនៅរុស្ស៊ីនេះឲ